I'm telling y'all, my mom has never even insulted me like that.
Hey!
Boy, your body is a mountain. She wanna roll with the man them. When I drop, you know it's an anthem. Oof. Girl, you wanna play with a big playboy like me. Oof. Girl, you wanna play with a big playboy like me.
What's good, YouTube? Welcome back to another freaking video. You get me? Hey, I appreciate all the love that y'all showed me on my first video, no cap. I appreciate all the love. I actually underestimated y'all. I'm gonna need y'all to do better though, so make sure you like, comment, and subscribe if you haven't done that already. And also, I need y'all to go follow me on my socials at playboy.p with two Y's, playboy.p with two Y's. Today, I got a story time for y'all. I think I'm calling this part of the channel Story Times with Playboy. Y'all fuck with it? Y'all let me know in the comment section y'all fuck with Story Times with Playboy. But today, I got a story time about my experience at BT. If y'all didn't know, I was a groom for a day. Today, I'm just gonna tell y'all about the experience, how it went. You know what I'm saying? I don't know how it's gonna get. But so yeah, without further ado, let's get right into the story. I got some story pointers on my phone. So if y'all see me looking back and forth from like the camera, I'm just like going through the pointers. On January, let's scroll, hold on. January 16th, so I got a proposal from the Virginia Tech board. They wanted me, your boy, like, you know, they wanted me, your boy, to be the groom. And I said, I thought about it. Out of everybody, they might have a reason to choose me as a groom, you get me? So I took upon the proposal after I prayed. Yeah, I talked to my peoples and it was the right decision to be the groom. Basically, the agreement was obviously be the groom for the day, and obviously they was gonna take care of everything else, such as gas, my outfits that I was gonna be wearing for that event. Like, all I had to do was, you know what I'm saying, just bring my leg, like, you get me? But that was the agreement. Mind you, only about, I would say about 5 hours, a good 5-6 hours to BT, you get me? So yeah, just so y'all know how far it is, y'all didn't know. So I did a 5-6 hour drive, right? I get there, everything is good, you know what I'm saying? I'm feeling the vibe. We settled in, I went with a couple of my friends actually. We all sat in there, everything was good. We then went to the first rehearsal, which was at the school. I liked the vibes, everything was clicking. You get me? Everything was clicking, but hey, we're about to get to the spicy part. Hereby, we're done with the first practice, right? We're basically driving back home, and they saying, for some reason, the outfits were not gonna get here until the wedding date. So it was March 25th. That was the wedding date. I forgot to mention that to y'all. So yeah, so we get there, you know what I'm saying? We get there a day or two early. So mind you, I wasn't informed about outfits. Wasn't gonna get there until the day of the event. The day of the event is the 25th, like I told y'all. And it said the outfits wouldn't get there to the day of the event. I was informed at the first rehearsal. Of course, I packed a couple things like that I knew was gonna come in handy. We've been chatting, I'm telling you, weeks before the event, and nobody has told me to pack extra things just in case the outfits don't, you know what I'm saying, don't get there. And I'm over here thinking like, okay, outfits about to come the day of the event, so like, you know what I'm saying, we're still gonna have the time, yeah. If I take an event or anything I'm doing that I know that my persona is on the line, I make sure I gotta protect it. I didn't want to just show or put any type of show out there for people to see, because that's my brand. If you see my brand, I want you to see what I want you to, you know what I'm saying? That same evening after the first rehearsal, they assigned a couple people to call and make sure like the outfits, if we could pick it up from the last shipment location. The last shipment location was like a couple hours from the school. When I say couple hours, I mean couple hours, you get me? So it was a couple hours away from the school, and then they decided to attempt to go get the outfits. And mind you, this wasn't just the groom's outfit. Let me just make that clear for y'all. This was not just the groom's outfit. It was everybody's outfit that was mainly on the event. I'm talking about the dancers don't got it, model, whatever, groom don't got it, the bride don't got it. At this point, this show is not happening because it's the day of the event and nobody got the outfit. Like, everybody's like calling, you know what I'm saying, these shipment places to figure out what we're gonna do. next morning, I'm talking about the day of the event, company people went out to go like get the outfit, and they said it wasn't there, like it wasn't at the last shipping post. Nobody has the outfit, nobody has even tried this outfit to make sure like they're looking right before the show. Like, I'm talking about day of the event, right? They told me to come to practice at 11 a.m. Mind you, I'm saying I'm new to the area, so like I had a couple of difficulties and like along the way. So I got to practice, I would say roughly around 11:30 maybe. I sat there for damn near hours, bro. Hours just to get told the outfit wasn't coming. But at this point, the outfits are not even an option on the table for the event. I didn't really pack anything that was like groom attire, if you understand. Like, I didn't really pack because I wasn't ready for all that, and I wasn't told during the weekly chat. But they gave me options left on the table for the event to still go on, such as like Kentae. All my guy needs, y'all know, if y'all know Kentae, like I'm gonna put a picture right here. Like, Kentae is not something you can just like put on and just be comfortable doing a like a whole event. I'm not really used to the Kentae like that. So the options were Kentae or to look for other people that match my profile, like, and wear their shirts or like a suit or something. Obviously pick people that match my profile because I know that Kentae wasn't gonna be an easy going for me. They had me running around this campus now trying to find people that match my profile and wear their clothes for the event.
Well, currently, nigga, we're still finding where the outfit comes out.
We're lost. I'm getting frustrated because I'm not really supposed to be in this position right now. Most of these outfits they sent me out to was not even fitting. It was people not even matching my profiles.
But my bro, like, I'm tired of my bread. Like, I'm my bread. Like, bro, I've been walking 10,500 steps.
The whole situation was just tired. And then I get a call from them saying they found a suit and they got a white shirt for me. I brought my own black dress pants. Like I told you, I brought like certain stuff, but nothing really major. So I get to the place where I was supposed to meet them and like try on the suit and the shirt. And I'm gonna insert clips like in the video so y'all see what I'm talking about. So at this point, y'all seen the shirt. It wasn't even like really anything that I could work with. So guys, I tried on the shirt and the suit and nothing was really fitting. So I took it back to them, right? And when I took it back, all I said was like, nothing is really working for me. So at this point, what are we supposed to do? I'm telling y'all, my mom has never even insulted me like that. Hey, bro, no cap. I got spaz on. So I'm the main event for tonight, you get me? And you're gonna spaz on me? After all, I've been like, respectful, and I said I've been cool, calm, collected since I got there, even when they told me that the outfits wasn't gonna get there until the day of the event, and I wasn't told that to bring any extra spare clothes or nothing. I'm asking the people that are around me like what's the right thing to do because nothing was really working for me. The shirt was not what I thought it was gonna be. The suit was up onto my elbow. I'm on the phone with my mom, laying her into my situation. And then she just tells me to just do the show. I talked to my friends, I said I was still gonna do the show because mind you, these people on the board, some people are like I'm actually close with outside of the organization that they have. I didn't really wanna cancel the show on them and I didn't really wanna cancel the show on people that came out to watch me. I called one of the board members and let them know that I was gonna still do the show. So I decided to go buy a whole new suit and like tie, shirt, whatever, to still do the show. And I'm gonna put like the receipts and everything in the video so y'all understand and have a better vision of what I'm talking about. The show was supposed to start at 7 o'clock. At this point, it's about 5 o'clock. We're talking about 5 o'clock. That's when I was saying we left the practice hall. It was 5 o'clock and I had to drive 40 minutes to Men's Warehouse, 40 minutes back before the show starts. Shout out the lady who like helped us at Men's Warehouse. I literally had to spend under 5 minutes, like, because if I spent any more time than that, like, I was gonna be late for the show. I'm on the way, everybody's tired, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, bro, I don't even wanna do the show anymore. Like, I'm so down. And I'm just thinking. So we're heading back from Men's Warehouse. So at this point, I would say it's about 6 o'clock. The show starts at 7. I'm getting ready. And then I get a call. Dun, 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 dun. Hello, I'm like, hello? And then there's one of the board members. And she's talking about, is this Prince? I say, yeah. She said, how long do you think you need? And I'm like, I'm getting ready. So I'm probably like in the next 30 to an hour. Mind you, I came with my friends and like, everybody needs to like get ready. You get me? I can't just leave. She says, oh, do you think you can be any faster? We need you at the event right at 7 o'clock, the show starts. I was shocked. I was like, with everything going on, I still go out of my way to go purchase everything. At least stretch out the show till I get there or something. I didn't get back to my room to get ready till about 6:40. So I'm shocked, I'm down, and I still go to the show. I still did my thing, and I'm gonna put some videos in here, like, of the wedding.
Since the first day I met you, I haven't set my eyes upon any other woman. I know you're the one for me.
I promise to love you today, tomorrow, next week, next month.
Acting like there was nothing going on behind the scenes. The show is almost done, right? And then there's a complaint that the building has to be closed before the end of the scene of the wedding. I didn't even know anything about this. Everything going on, I didn't like, I'm not aware. The show didn't even go as planned, bro. Like, I'm talking about it did not even end right. Overall, just the hospitality, like the communication was just like terrible. I was left alone just to figure out everything. That's the main event of your show. At this point, we call it an L night and left. If I had canceled the show right now, they wouldn't be having the main event for the ASA night and no after party, which means you lost revenue, correct? We decided to go to the after party. I decided to go to the after party with the group that I came with. We get there, we at the door, and it said, oh, like you're good. But the people that you came with are not good. Not to be rude or anything, like, I put my money down for your show to still go on, right? And then we get to the door and then you're asking me to pay for the people that I came with. I came with 3 people and y'all say y'all can't accommodate them for an after party. This was nothing but a $2 ticket to enter the party. So about $6, right? You would rather charge me $6 when I throw the money for your event to still go on and for you to still even have an after party. We've already had an L wedding event, so just call it a night and just like have fun, make whatever out of it. I decided to pay for the people that I came with because they couldn't get into the party because of $2. Called it L night and left. Overall, my experience at Virginia Tech was like, this time was 2, bro. I rated it 2 out of 10, bro, if you ask me. Shout out to all the people that actually made it like worth it with everything else that was going on. You get me? Like, with everything else, there was a couple people behind the scenes that was actually making our stay worth it. But I really come back, I don't know. I still hold like the utmost respect for the ASA board members. I know it was completely not their fault, but next time I feel like y'all can do better. Specifically, like just for choosing me to be your, let's say, the groom, because they could have really chose everybody and they gave me that opportunity to get on that platform. And I appreciate y'all for that. I know how y'all do, like it was just a bad event overall this time, but still all love on this side. I still hold the utmost respect for the ASA board members, man. Shout out all of them. Anyways, YouTube. Without further ado, I'm just gonna go ahead and wrap up the YouTube video. Thank y'all for tuning in to Story Times with Playboy. I'm gonna try and do better, like going on. And yeah, just stay tuned for my next video. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And we out.